welcome again to the sessions on OSINT, the streams. Let's go ahead and dive right in. Today we're going to be discussing language analysis in OSINT investigations. And this is a pretty powerful technique, something worth diving into because it's something that affords us the ability to attempt to perform different types of attribution. When we talk about or think about language analysis, there's a few things that come to mind. And honestly, this is going to be a fairly quick session today. This won't be as long as normal, but we think about translation. But we also need to think about things like patterns, things like the Queen's English versus US English. How do they spell the word organize? Are there any common terms, phrases, hashtags, or nuances that you can see within the text? This basically allows the ability to fingerprint a person or an entity to a degree. Same thing with commonly misspelled words. Do they commonly misspell occasionally? For example, if someone sends me a text message with a link and it replaces .com with .con, I know they're using an iPhone because that's an iPhone problem. Also, euphemisms, figures of speech, etc. Those are things that may be regional or based on a specific dialect or something to that effect. And in that regard, that affords us the ability to find out more about the person. While it's not necessarily directly related, you should also consider assessing times of day so that you can ascertain the time zone. Recently, Facebook took down a disinformation campaign that was attributed to the U.S. Department of Defense because they only posted during normal U.S. working hours. Also, factor in days of week. In some parts of the world, you don't work on certain days of the week. That could also be based upon religion as well. And then look at the virality of the content. Is this something that is just going hyper viral for no reason? Is it bots? Is it because it's something that's legitimately concerning? Those are all things to consider when we are talking about language analysis. And with that, I'm going to give you four translation sites. Two of them you're probably familiar with. The first is Lingui, and then we have DeepL, Yandex, and Google. And to that end, I've got them pulled up here, and I'm going to open OCR.space from the presentation yesterday. And I am going to pull up, as soon as I get to the Finder, here we go. Bear with me just a moment while I get the image, but I'm going to use the same image that we used yesterday to get the translation in Russian. So we have this, and this is all I was looking for here. So I'm just going to remove that, and we can drop it here in Lingui, because Lingui allows us to go English to Russian, but in this case, we want to go Russian to English. For whatever reason, it's not wanting to cooperate with us. So this pulls it apart. This is doing more of a dictionary type thing. So it's saying downtown, in the center of, and this doesn't really work for the big phrase, like something this long. This just works more for a single word. We can go over to DeepL and just leave it on detect language and do the same thing. And this will tell us pretty much the same thing, but then we can click on a particular word and we get the definition, in this case, of metro. So this is pretty useful in this context, and it also supports 31 languages. This is based off of machine learning as opposed to just the standard translate with these platforms. I will say that if I'm translating something from a Russian, a Slavic, or a Cyrillic language, I will tend to favor Yandex over Google. But ultimately, the results are going to be pretty much the same. So that's something to keep in mind. Over here, I've got this pulled up, the word malus in Persian. I was doing an investigation, and it was for a client that believed that the perpetrator of the, we'll say, malicious activity was of Persian descent. And the account that was harassing the client account had the word malus in the username. And I took a semester of Arabic, but I'm not proficient by any stretch of the imagination. I do remember a few things, like my instructor saying things like, I got as frustrated as an Arabic lip reader, because within the language, you don't have to move your lips and your mouth that much. He explained that that was partially because of, in some parts of the Arab world, heat, and in some parts, sand. So they developed a language that they didn't have to move their mouth a lot for, so that they didn't get overly dehydrated or sand in their mouth. So while doing the investigation, I tried everything that I would normally do with username analysis. I tried all the other things that I would do with, in this case, it was Instagram. And I was sitting at my desk, and I make it a practice to say words aloud. And in this case, I say melus, and I was able to do it without really moving my chin. And I was like, okay, Persian is a very similar language to Arabic. Let's see what this means. And turns out the word malus means cute. And one of the people that was the client was a woman. So that's exactly what it ties to. The final thing I'll show you today deals with, this is a tool that I wrote called Hashy. I've used this in investigating the alt-right, as well as other things dealing with Twitter. I saw today where Twitter is doing away with their free API on February 9th. So this will work until then. And then if you pay for an API after that, then it would work as well. But this relies on the Twitter API. And basically, this is just importing everything. We are just going to pull tweets with these four words or these four hashtags. And what it's going to do is it's also going to pull neighboring hashtags for us. So I've already got it ready to go. So literally, I'm just going to say log in right here and let it run. So it's doing the initial analysis of these hashtags. OSINT had 11 occurrences, uppercase, 3 lowercase, red team, forensics, breaking, infosec, bug bounty, hate mail, hacking. And then it does the frequency analysis. I did this somewhat for the purpose of marketing, because Instagram allows up to 30 hashtags. And obviously it's based on the quality of the hashtags. So with this, it continues. It's looking for the word recon as well, OPSEC, and you can see the list is just building out, and it's doing the frequency analysis more and more. And then this adds SOC Mint to it. So this gives us the top hashtags to use in order. And right here, number 29, that's the 30th one because we start on 0. But in that regard, if we wanted to use all of these hashtags, these would be the most impactful. Honestly, if I were doing something for the purpose of social media, I would include the top ones, less Ukraine, unless it was something directly related to Ukraine. I would pull the ones that are obviously not relevant out. And then we also have the CSVs that we can open. So this shows the neighboring hashtag. In this case, it was OSINT and Ukraine. And it's just the tweet. We can see what the tweet says. And we can do that with all of these things. So it's pretty interesting. And then with the actual frequency analysis, this shows us everything so that we can pull it down as well. I've taken this script a little bit further, not in this particular context, but let me see if I can open up another one here. This was the most recent one. So you can even go further and create a word cloud with it. And as you can see, 6 months ago, we had words like Ukraine, Moldova, Israel, Anonymous, Romania. All of these things were included with this as well. So this is hashy. I'll release it at some point. I'm not sure when, but that's dealing with language analysis. It's just something to be aware of. With that being said, that's the end of the content for today. So be sure to do the stream survey, osint.mobi/stream-survey. That is to find out feedback in terms of the format and periodicity of these streams. In terms of suggesting content or submitting questions, it's osint.mobi/stream-questions. If you want to submit questions for next week's AMA with Trace Labs, that's at osint.mobi/submit-AMA-questions. With that AMA, it's going to include Baluv, Levy, Aleth Dennis, and myself. It's going to be next Wednesday from 7 to 9 p.m. Eastern Time on Twitch, osint.mobi/twitch. It may not last the full 2 hours, but we've got 2 hours allotted for it. The next day, on February 9th, we'll be running a webinar with Monica Camacho talking about finding reference sources for geolocation when Google Maps doesn't cut it. You can register for that at osint.mobi/February-webinar. Because there are no sponsors, there is a $10 fee. You can find me on Twitter, Discord, and other platforms at C_3PJoe. The Ascension is at The Ascension. There are the links to LinkedIn and other platforms. If you are interested in training, you can go to theoscension.com/courses. Our on-demand courses are at academy.theoscension.com. We're streaming on twitch.tv/theoscension. We're also on YouTube at theoscension9198. And you can join our Discord community at osint.mobi/discord. Feel free to like and follow us on Twitter. Like and follow us, subscribe, set up notifications on YouTube and Twitch. And beyond that, that's all I've got for today. I don't have the schedule for next week, but with that being said, I will put the schedule out when I know what it's going to look like. It's probably not going to be at 6 p.m., so I'm not entirely sure what that will look like. So watch the social media platforms for that. Besides that, thanks. Have a great day.
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the bell for notifications.